Now we are going to solve example 3.5, and example 3.5 is basically a three-dimensional problem. And this problem is that, let me read the statement of this problem. An infinitely long rectangular metal pipe, which is of side A and B, is grounded, but one end at x equal to 0 is maintained at a specified potential V0YZ, and we are supposed to find out the potential on inside this rectangular pipe. So it's a rectangular pipe, and it is open on this side and it is closed on this side. The side on which it is closed is maintained at a potential V naught, which is a function of y and z, because it is extending along y and along z. And as the potential is going along x-axis, so we are having three dimensionals involved here, and for that it's a three-dimensional problem, and we will have to solve this example. So it's from its geometry, it's a three-dimensional problem. So pi partial square of x we have of v here, plus partial square over partial x square of v, plus partial square over partial z square. This is y square, and this is z square of v, is equal to 0. And we are going to solve this thing. Let me discuss the boundary conditions here. The boundary conditions will become, as we are having three dimensions, so the boundary condition will be 6 in this case now. So V is 0 when Y is equal to 0. When Y is 0, this is Y 0, and V is 0 over there. And when we have V equal to 0, when y is equal to a, means when y is equal to a, we are having the potential 0, we are reaching the other plate here. And third, on the z axis we are having two conditions, that v is equal to 0 when z is equal to 0. So z is equal to 0 here, it is this plate basically, and v is equal to 0 here, and v is also 0 here when z is equal to b. So we are at the end of this plate basically. Similarly, on the x-axis, we are having the fifth boundary condition, and that is that V goes to 0. This is just like example 3.3, that V goes to 0 when x goes to infinity. Means along this side, as we go on, this x goes to infinity, then we will have the V naught goes to 0. The potential will go to 0. V naught is there, while the V, which we will find, it will go to 0. And the sixth boundary condition on this one is that V equals V naught, and this is a function of Y and Z. This is where this is at x equal to 0. When x is 0, then means when this x comes here, then we are having this enclosed plate we have here, on which we are closing this pipe. Then this is equal at x equal to 0, this has a potential equal to V naught. So we will again use the separation of variable technique, and the separation of variable technique is that we suppose that V, which is a function of x, y, z, we are writing it in three different potentials. X, capital X, is a potential which is depending on x only, and capital Y is a potential which depends on y, and capital Z is a potential which depends on the z variable. So we are having the potential equal to this. This I can write now is capital X, Y, and Z. Now, if I put x, y, z here, then I will get that curly square means when I am not doing these steps, they are easy. V equal x, y, z. So, x will remain here while y, z will come outside. Similarly, here y will remain here and x, z will come out. And here z will remain while x and y will come out. And when we divide this whole by x, y, z, then the y, z which was earlier here will cancel and only 1 over x will remain. And this is partial square. V and is we are now having the x here or here x will remain, so the partial will become a complete derivative here, d square x over d x square. Similarly, 1 over y and d square y over d y square plus 1 over z and d square z over d z square. We will have to keep one thing in mind that capital X, Y, Z are not variables, they are basically potentials. So our equation is like this. Now this equation as a whole is equal to zero. It means that either individual all terms are equal to zero or the sum of one or two is equal to the third. So any case means we are having zero. So we are doing one supposition here that we say that let's say this is equal to a constant C1 while this is equal to a constant C2 and this is equal to a constant C3. Now in this situation we will have the C1 plus C2 plus C3 equals to 0. And now we say that these C1, C2 and C3, let's say we take this C1, if I take this positive, then I take their sum, then their sum will be negative. Like if I consider that this is positive and I consider the sum of these two is negative and they are equal, and then it will be equal to zero. So for this means this is just a mathematical trick that I am using. I will write that because here I am having one thing in mind, means the mathematical trick is not just applied abruptly, means I am having in mind that my potential is a function of y and z, so I am combining the y and z component here while keeping the x is outside of it. So if I see, I suppose that this c2 is equal to minus k square and the C3 is equal to minus L square, then it means that C1 plus C2 will be minus K square plus L squared. And then I can write that then C1 automatically then comes out to be plus k square L square. So I can write that d square x over d x square is equal to plus k square L square, and then it will be with capital X. Like here, this thing is equal to C1 and C1 equal to plus of that thing, and it is this equation. Similarly, d square y over dy square, d square y over dy square is equal to minus k square, and it will be with capital Y, while d square z over dz square is equal to minus L square, and Z will come with it.